Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi, my name is Abida Miguel Jamal Murphy. People usually call me Abid. So today we are going to talk about self-discovery slash self-acknowledgement in order to gain your confidence and to boost your self-esteem as well. So before we start, usually people associate self-confidence and also self-esteem with comparing themselves to with other people, especially their peers. Like, I always hear this word, like, that person always gets an A for the course, that person is smart, or she's so pretty, look at her flawless skin. First of all, stop comparing yourself with other people, because that is not good, it's not healthy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created and fashioned you the way you are because you are unique, because you have your own flaws, you have your own strength that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. So if you compare yourself with other people, especially on your physical self, like your face or your teeth or your eyes or your hair or your muscles, I don't know, that's not good. Although comparing in general is good indicator whether you're doing well or not, but in this case, when you compare yourself with others, that to the point that you hate yourself, to the point that you blame yourself for not being like other people, that's toxic. So you should stop. So instead of focusing on your physical self, which you cannot change, why don't you divert your attention and divert your energy to improving your soft skills? Why? Because soft skills can be learned, soft skills can be mastered, and soft skills can be applied in your daily life, and it is very, very important for yourself as well. How do you actually improve your soft skills? For me, there are a lot of ways on how to improve your soft skills. For university students like us, I believe one of the ways is to join a lot of societies, a lot of clubs, and also a lot of programs. Joining these clubs, societies, programs will improve your skills tremendously, I would say. Yes, for me personally, because of joining this club, societies, programs, I'm able to find what my strengths are, my weaknesses are, my threats, and also my opportunity, or the opportunity that is held for my sense of skills. So if you are able to do this SWOT analysis on your soft skills, you will be able to gain the confidence that you should have and eventually boost your self-esteem. So I guess that's all for me today. Thank you. Assalamualaikum.